Hello, everyone. Today, I want to talk about She-Hulk twerking. Now, She-Hulk twerking has been in the news for at least a week, and a lot of men have been losing their minds over it. You see, men don't like women. Men don't even see women as people. Men see women as things, as objects. Men don't like women very much. So we'll talk a bit about the twerking scene, just to see why all these men are wrong about it. First off, let me please ask you all to subscribe to my channel and click that notification bell for, well, notifications. Well, let's get started, all right? Here we go.
And this is where another big viral Twitter clip comes in of people making fun of the show. At the end of that episode, that's episode 3, there's a post-credit scene where She-Hulk is twerking with Megan Thee Stallion. And yeah, you know what? It's pretty cringe, but it doesn't bother me. I don't care. It's a post-credit scene. Let them have fun. I don't know why people are making a big hoopla about it.
In theory, I don't have a problem with She-Hulk and Megan Thee Stallion twerking in a post-credit scene. In theory. In practice, however, I hate it. I'm probably the only person who hates that scene for the reason that I'm going to talk about in a few minutes here.
It's just the whole show itself isn't very good.
Hi, there's my new favorite client. Just your signature there.
Mitt Trap, I know you ain't going to let it go down like this, nigga. I bet y'all niggas thought it wasn't coming. I bet you thought it wasn't coming.
Just your signature there. And then just...
But they still wanna know we're making it. Talking like a...
Mitt Trap, I know you ain't gonna let it go down like this, nigga. I'm hearing niggas on the gram saying you fell off, saying you ain't got it no more. But you started this shit, so let these niggas know what it is. Niggas out here jocking your slang, they ain't even down with your game. Mick Savage Life, nigga. It's Mitt Trap or die. Mitt Trap high battles. I bet y'all niggas thought it wasn't coming. I bet you thought it wasn't coming. Tell them what it is, Mitt Trap.
Last time I checked, it was the man on these streets. They call me residue, I leave blown. Diarrhea flow, flow, shit on niggas. Hate it when I'm constipated, steal shit on niggas. Ooh. Got some super friends in the Legion of Doom. Say my name the wrong way, then you're meeting your doom. Ooh. It's time to clean shop, I ain't needing the broom. I just gave you bitch a molly and the key to my room. Ooh, I see these haters just don't get it yet. Hey. Along with respect, hey. Along with a check. Hey. I'm going at next, told you I'm a savage. Ooh. Fuck with me the wrong way, make coleslaw out your been a motherfucking beast.
Beast.
Real savage off the leash.
Leash.
Ride around in that priest. Passenger seat, probably got you free. Oh, my bad, that you fucking old lady. Niggas talking shit about me, niggas so shady. But I don't give a damn, and I probably never will. Say the wrong thing, need to go on the right wheel. For real. Ooh, I'm the truth, nigga, no lie. These bitches ain't leaving.
Alright, so the problem I have with this scene is how she's dressed. And it goes back to what I've been complaining about now for a while with feminism, or this modern day version of feminism, this sex negative, anti-male gaze. Male gaze is not even a thing, but...
You cannot just, you know, wade into film criticism and start talking about the male gaze without knowing something about the history of art, okay, and a perspective and a vision and so on, okay? The male gaze is a foolish idea. Should have long ago been discarded.
I hate how, if you speak out against feminism, it's treated as if you're anti-woman, as if feminism is just the default for society, that everybody understands that if you really care about women, then you have to be a feminist. To the point where I know that there were people being mocked, you know, online, where if, you know, you would ask someone, a man, are you feminist? And if they replied, well, I'm a humanist, then it's like, oh, that's just meaning you don't like women and you're a misogynist and you can't say it. Sort of like, you know, all lives matter versus black lives matter, something like that. But the thing is, at this point in time, feminists are sex negative, they're anti-male, they're anti-feminine, and they want to get away with destroying male-targeted properties because they don't believe men should have anything to themselves. They believe that the default should be women, and that if you want to go off by yourself and have your own things and your own attitudes and your own entertainments, then something is wrong with you and you're a danger to society. The default is men are bad. So even if they like an attractive woman, that's bad, that's evil. Because these people are crazy. So the reason why I keep saying feminist or SJW is because I am not talking about women writers who can write, or women directors who can direct, or women artists, period. I'm not talking about women when I say that these women suck. Like, I'm talking about the feminists who go out of their way to take She-Hulk, who was a sex symbol in the comics, fun. It wasn't just about her being a sex symbol, but she was a sex symbol. She was sexy. Like, when she dressed in her lawyer clothes, they were sexy outfits. They looked good. They were stylish. Now they dress her and she looks like Hillary Clinton or Herman Munster. It's ridiculous. So the thing I hate about this twerk scene is that they've taken anything. Twerking is a sexually provocative act. Like, I don't care if you approve of it or not. I think in context it's fine. You know, you have entertainers or performers doing it for whatever reason. I feel like they're not a part of regular everyday society. So it's weird to be like, well, Audrey Hepburn wouldn't twerk. Why would she? What environment would she be in? Whatever. I don't care. The thing is, if you're going to have two women twerking, whether it's in a lawyer office, I don't care about that. It's just that, to me, I think it's funny that, like taking She-Hulk and turning her into a feminist icon, you take twerking and you turn it into something that a bunch of wine moms and wine aunts could look at and go, ooh, child, that's so funny. Like, if you saw a little girl, like, there could be, like, some, I don't know, viral video of a little kid dancing and twerking, so to speak, and everybody thinks it's funny and cute. She's got a pamper on, and everybody thinks it's funny. And that's how they're treating the twerking in this scene. And it's like, I'm looking at She-Hulk. She's dressed like Hillary Clinton in this horrible, ugly, and at least Hillary Clinton usually was wearing more color. She's got this ugly, gray, drab suit on. Not a skirt. She got pants on. She got these huge, ugly-ass shoes. Look like goddamn Frankenstein. And she's been wearing this thing, I guess, since episode 2 on. I don't know. I haven't watched every individual episode. But I was like, why are they like, they're purposely making her look drab and stupid. And they're just not saying anything about it. I'm like, is it because they don't have that much money? They don't want to, you know, spend too much money changing her outfit every time they do the effects for her, the CGI. I mean, she looks terrible anyway. She looks like damn Shrek's wife. She really does. The stupid eyes, the weird color, kind of the way she moves. She just looks weird and stupid. But I was like, well, they must be dressing her drab just so, even though, okay, because there was a point in, I think it was on Twitter, when I was on Twitter, before I got kicked off, I was on Twitter at one point, and the special effects, allegedly some special effects artists were complaining that they didn't get to make She-Hulk look more muscular and more manly. Like, they wanted her to look like she's looked in the past few years in the comics. For the past, I don't know how many years, 5-6 years maybe? Maybe not that long. She's looked like a monstrosity. Like, they've made her ugly on purpose. They actually made her She-Hulk form really fucking stupid. They made her want to be She-Hulk. I mean, sorry, they made her want to be Jen and not She-Hulk. They just completely changed everything about her personality. So the one good thing about the show was where they made her look more like her original self. But, like, again, the visual effects are terrible, so she doesn't look that good. She doesn't, definitely doesn't look attractive. The twerk scene, again, she looks like she's wearing a pamper. That's what my brother said. She looks like either she's wearing a pamper or, like, this potato sack. So they're focusing on something that just, there's nothing there. Like, hell, Angelina Jolie, the visual effects that they did for her character in the Beowulf movie, that character looks sexy, and it was like, you know, digital effects or whatever. But anyway, I don't know. It's just, the feminist project is just to make everything look ugly and drab and unattractive. And so it's annoying that, again, they're appropriating something. Cultural appropriation, no, but they're appropriating something that should be sexually provocative. But like I said, if you are against that, that's fine. That's not the issue for me. I'm sitting there going, if you're going to do a twerk scene, then why are you making it just look silly and dumb, unattractive, and you have She-Hulk dressed like a dude, and she looks like Frankenstein. It's ridiculous. Frankenstein's monster. Oh, yeah, and it looks like they did make some comment about the suit that she's wearing. Her little paralegal or whatever told her, we need to do something about your look. And the thing is, I don't know if they think this is funny to have scenes of Jan walking around in a suit that's like two, three sizes too big for her, and she looks like a kid playing dress up or something, or if they're just so stupid that they're being extra, ultra practical so that it'll make sense to normies that when she turns into She-Hulk, her clothes don't just come immediately rip off every time. All they had to do was have a scene in the first episode when she's training with Bruce or whatever, or, you know, emasculating Bruce. All they had to do was just say, hey, look, Bruce could have just said, hey, look, you know, now that you're a Hulk, you're going to need new clothes. You're going to need a new wardrobe. So just head on over to Stark Industries. Let them know what's going on with your situation. They'll hook you up. I mean, he could be like, they have a scientist there who works on unstable molecules. That's what I use now. That's why I can wear this T-shirt that fits my frame and these goddamn shorts or whatever. Or if you don't want to do that deep dive and hint around about Mr. Fantastic, you know, working with Stark Industries in the MCU, then you could just say, hey, look, they're using nanotechnology to make clothes fit people like us and to survive wear and tear when we're fighting battles or whatever. That's all he had to say. And he could even had a little storyline or a little scene where when she goes to Stark Industries or have Stark Industries come to her, and it could be a tech person and some stereotypical flamboyant fashion designer who wants to do her measurements and talk about all the, you know, trendy fashion he's going to do for her. They could have done all kinds of stuff instead of having her walk around looking like a complete, like, clown. But they're more interested, I think, in defeating the male gaze than they are in anything else.
And it's not as if in gay culture there we don't find the male gaze. I mean, gay males enjoy looking at pictures of beautiful, yes, idealized.
And gay, there you have just disproved the stupid theory, okay? Because gay men know when they look at a beautiful young man, okay, that they are not creating some sort of powerful subordination, okay, you know, on that man, okay? They know they're looking up in admiration at that beauty, okay? This has been part of Western art since the Greeks,
and it's how,